You have to go through everything that you can, get over those, and then you can go and level up. So today is my intent to leave you with information that will allow you to level up both personally and professionally in life, all right? So a lot of times when it comes to where we are today and we think about where it is that we want to be, if someone were to ask you the question, well, what's the next thing you want to do? A lot of pressure, right? And this, again, could be personally or professionally, even when it comes to the dating sites, when they say, hey, tell me about yourself. Now, you've read bios where people say, well, I like long walks on the beach, my favorite color is this, my favorite food is this. And if you don't know yourself enough, you really don't know how to answer that question, whether it's personally or professionally. So what I want to challenge you to do today is, I want you to tap into your inner kid and pretend that it's Christmas Eve. So what does Santa Claus tell you to do? Make a list and check it twice. So if you look at the worksheet in front of you, you have a list. I want you to think of three things that you want to try. Anything that you've never done, whether it's skydiving or you want to be a director in a department, whatever it is you can think of three things. So I see a lot of people are either jotting down really quickly or they're stumped, which is a good thing. It's making you think. So now that I see the majority of the room has written down three things that they want to try, I advise you to do one thing that we tease one of my aunts. So I have an aunt, and she always claims every year at the beginning of the year she's going to be on a diet. So she's going to cut back. She's not gonna eat as much food as she normally would, but whenever we have a family gathering, she's gonna try it. Oh, what is that you have? Let me try it. What do you have? I'm gonna try it. So what I really wanna advise you guys to do is be on a try it. But the mission here is for you to be able to explore. So the next step in leveling up is, you've ever heard that statement, check yourself before you wreck yourself? And if you're familiar with it, what it really, really means is you have to do a self-assessment. Now, no one's perfect. At least I know I am not. I would like to be, but I know that there are things that I would like to work on. I know that there are things, internal qualities in myself that I would like to work on that would make me a better person. So what I would like for you guys to do is to assess yourself. And I don't want you to write a list of 10 different things. Only one thing that you would do for yourself that would allow you to grow. Please write it down. Just one. Now, while you're writing that down, I want to talk to you a little bit about growth. And if anyone was around in the 80s, I know I wasn't the only one, there was a commercial of this new fad called a chia pet, right? And the commercial would come on and it would say, cha-cha-cha-chia, and all of a sudden you have this plant that grew overnight, right? That is not how we grow internally. It's not an overnight process. And if anyone in here is familiar with the Chinese bamboo tree story, has anyone ever heard of it? Anyone? Okay, so I'm going to read this to you because I really want you to be able to soak this in. The Chinese bamboo tree is planted after the earth is prepared. And for the first 4 years, all of the growth is underground. The only thing visible above the ground is a little bulb with a small shoot coming out of it. Each year, the tree is fertilized, cultivated, and watered, and still no growth is visible. Then in the fifth year, the bamboo tree grows up to 30 meters in 6 weeks. That's how you will grow. That's how you'll be able to tell. So tomorrow, you're not gonna be magically another person. It takes time. It takes cultivating just like a plant. You have to water it, you have to give it a little TLC, and then eventually you will grow. That's the next mission. Grow. So if you know me personally, you know I really love movies, and I like to allude to them. Does anyone know where these images, where does it come from? Mike?
The Devil Wears Prada.
The Devil Wears Prada. Prada. Very good. Has everyone seen that movie? No. No problem. So just a quick synopsis of the movie. I think it came out in about 2006, and here's the actress Anne Hathaway. So she was a recent college graduate in pursuit of her dream job, and she wanted to be a journalist. And she ended up with what wasn't an ideal job for her, but it was actually a job that everyone said in the movie people would die for. So she ended up at a fashion magazine. So this is how she arrived on her first day. Not really a fashionista, right? And once she got there, she realized her boss was the boss from hell. Because her boss was this extreme fashionista. And she judged your appearance at every moment that she was given the opportunity to. So Anne Hathaway decided that in order for her to survive her stair-stepper job, which everyone else would kill for, is she would actually have to change. So she started to consult with people in the actual company, and they gave her a little makeover, right? And through the movie, you understand that because she's changed, she's learned a lot about herself. And at the end, she really kind of, she looks polished, but not as, you know, frou-frou as one would expect someone that works at a fashion magazine would look. Now, if we all took this same approach, one thing that you really have to understand that you have to do is you have to change. Who you are today won't get you to the next level. So you have to change. And you can't change, again, like Anne. Anne took a minute. A couple weeks in, she changed. You have to change like a transformer. Within seconds, you have to be able to change. So I want you to look at your worksheet and write down one thing that you need to change. I'm not talking about an internal quality at this point. I'm talking about actions. How do you behave with people? How do you show up to work? Are you a sociable person? Are you a nice person? How do people perceive you? What is it that you need to change? And the overall mission is change. So there's another quote that I'm sure everyone is familiar with, and it just floats around from time to time. They say it's not what you know, it's right. I've heard that, and I've heard different variations of that phrase. But what I've been told recently, and it's really helped me a lot, is it's not what you know. Not who you know, but more importantly, is who knows you. And if you know a little bit about how things happen in corporate America, I'm just using this as an example, but I'm sure this is how things happen in life. So this is what I was told by an HR person that is no longer with the company, so I will not name him. But he said, if you really want to move to another department, you have to get in front of the job. And I didn't really understand what he meant. So what he said was, you have to go into the department, you have to make friends, you have to basically let them know who you are and let them know what your mission is. And what should happen is, even if you go to a department and say, hey, I'm really interested in being the secretary, the day that you go, the secretary position may not be available. However, before positions are posted, there is some sort of planning meeting. Someone, somewhere, has to sit around and say, hey, I think we need 5 or 6 more secretaries in this department. Now, if you were able to get in front of the job, you want your name to be attached to that specific job that you want. And the exact same thing happens when you're dealing with things personally. Let's say that you're interested in buying a 71 Mustang. You get to know people and you talk to them and you say, I'm really into older cars and I want to rehab them. And if you know anyone that has a 71 Mustang, just let me know. So if you say that in a room full of people, as we're driving down Paces Ferry Road, if we happen to see a 71 Mustang on the side of the road, you're gonna come to mind. But it doesn't happen in the reverse. Because a lot of times what happens is, because the person is in mind, connected to that position before it happens, by the time it's posted publicly, it's too late. So what I wanna challenge you today is to think about who knows you and who knows your next mission, whatever it is. If you're interested in buying a house, who knows that? If you're interested in a promotion, who knows that? And is it 3 people that you can name that knows it and will actually help connect you to the next level? I challenge you to write that down. 3 people. And if you can't name 3 people, you have some work to do. So this next mission is to be in the know. Now I want to challenge anyone in the room that can tell me all 4 missions today. Anyone, or at least name one. Maybe everyone else as a collective effort could tell you all 4.
Name 3 things.
Be in the know, that's a good one.
Change.
That's the one.
Grow.
Explore. Very good. Okay, so I have a very important takeaway for all of this. What I like to call a major key alert. None of these missions will work if you don't do one thing. And it doesn't really matter what you call it, but it really is persistence. And just to help you remember what that is, you have to take it from Diddy. So you can't stop, and you won't stop. When it comes to accomplishing your goals and leveling up in your life, you have to be persistent. If not, no one else will do it for you. So again, it's my intent to make sure that I've left you guys with a lot.